Already at track and field, it's a Jamaica versus U.S. headliner. Allison Felix wearing the red, white, and blue against Veronica Campbell Brown of Jamaica. Lane two is Debbie Ferguson McKenzie of the Bahamas, 32 years old, in her fourth Olympics, one of the golden girls from the 4x1 relay in the 2000 Olympics, and former Bulldog, Lady Bulldog at the University of Georgia.
Tom, had she gotten a better lane draw, I thought she could really do some damage. It's going to be tough from lane two. She has the experience, but that lane draw might have ruined her chances at seeing the podium.
Lane three, Sidonie Mothersill of the Cayman Islands, a semifinalist in Athens, a former ACC champion at Clemson University.
And she carried the flag for the Cayman Islands in the opening ceremonies. If she can hang on to Veronica Campbell-Brown to her outside, she does finish well.
Veronica Campbell-Brown is to her outside in lane four, the defending Olympic champion. She beat Allison Felix the very first time they met.
And she said that she's in the best shape of her life, and not after not making the Olympic team at 100 meters, she's gone on a tear. She has the top two best 200-meter times in the world this year.
Allison Felix in lane five. After losing to Veronica Campbell-Brown at Athens, she has beaten her head-to-head the last five times they've met.
But she has not looked like the Allison Felix we saw dominate Veronica Campbell-Brown last year at the World Championships. She's quite a bit slower, but she said she is ready, and she will have to get out and run.
Lane six, Karan Stewart of Jamaica, part of the Jamaican sweep in the 100, dead-heating for the silver.
The pride of St. Catherine, Jamaica, silver medalist already at these games. And she looks very relaxed. That's a good indication. Lane six, perfect for her. She's a taller athlete, gets her off that turn early.
Lane seven is American Marcia Vet Hooker.
A Marcia Vet at the Olympic trials for the USA waited late to run down some athletes on the home stretch. She cannot do that tonight. She has to be in it early to give herself a legitimate chance at a medal.
Marcia Vet, a former Texas Longhorn. Lane eight, Sharon Simpson of Jamaica. Again, she was part of that Jamaican sweep at 100 meters with the dead heat for second.
And her being in lane eight makes her very dangerous. She already has a medal. That's always a psychological edge. This is all icing. She already has the cake. And from lane eight, she's going to be very, very dangerous. She runs the turn extremely well and starts well.
And in lane nine is Muna Lee, fifth in the 100 meters last Sunday, and the former LSU All-American.
And Muna's in this outside lane because she did not run a particularly good semifinal. Disappointment for her, I'm sure, in that 100, not getting a medal. Here's a chance at redemption. I think this is her better event. Allison Felix on the left, Veronica Campbell-Brown on the right. Since 2004, when Campbell-Brown won, Allison Felix has dominated this matchup. But tonight, if Allison Felix does not run the first 50 meters and put herself within striking distance of Veronica Campbell-Brown, this race is going to look like a carbon copy of 2004, because you are not going to run down Veronica Campbell-Brown from behind.
Light rain has begun to fall here as we await the gun in the 200 meters. And it is a fair start. Veronica Campbell-Brown comes away quickly. So does Karan Stewart. And Allison Felix trying to keep pace. Muna Lee in the outside lane. Top of the home straightaway. Veronica Campbell-Brown is in front. Another Jamaican shows the way down the home stretch. Allison Felix trying to close Karan Stewart and Muna Lee. But it will be Veronica Campbell-Brown to get it. Allison Felix finishing second. The same 1-2 result as Athens.
And not just a great run, but a fantastic time. New personal best by almost, by more than 0.2 seconds for Veronica Campbell-Brown. And that looked exactly like the 2004 Athens final. Veronica Campbell-Brown has the collection of medals she does, including two golds now in successive 200-meter Olympic finals, because when the gun goes off, she is gone. This race was over at 50. She jumped on Allison Felix, something awful, and it was all downhill from there. Allison Felix never recovered, and she was never really pressed. And Allison Felix has to be happy. I am really surprised that she hung on for the silver, because quite frankly, the way she's been looking through the rounds, I thought it was possible that she could slip to bronze, the way Karan Stewart had been looking. She did well to hang on for the silver. So two consecutive bronzes, two consecutive silvers for Allyson Felix, and two consecutive golds for this lady here, Veronica Campbell Brown. So dominant because she does not falter. When the gun sounds, Veronica Campbell Brown, third from the right, jumps on Allyson Felix, and this is where she gets all the advantage she will need. At 100 meters, she's 2 meters clear, and as I said, this woman, since she lost at 100 meters at the Jamaican Olympic trials getting fourth, she has been unstoppable. She came here and defends her Olympic 200-meter crown and made it look easy. This was never in doubt. If you let Veronica Campbell Brown come off the turn ahead, you give yourself an uphill battle because she is so strong and so focused in a final, it is almost impossible to catch her from behind as Allyson Felix and Karan Stewart, as you see her to her right, find out. It simply is impossible to overhaul her in an Olympic final.
You saw how close Allyson was to her family, her dad, the former minister, and being consoled by them now. Allyson in tears.
And Tom, I'm very familiar with this family. I can tell you the disappointment on Allison's face is because she knew that she had a chance, given her last year's season, to come here and upset Veronica Campbell Brown. And I am sure that something has been wrong with Allyson through the round. She said she herself did not know what it was, but there has been something suspect in her form. She has not looked like the Allyson Felix of 2007. Take a look at Allyson Felix in between the two Jamaicans in the blue. Has not looked like herself all of 2008. You see a kind of up and down motion to her form, which is not normally there. And I think that's the reason why she was never really able to give Veronica Campbell Brown a good run for her money.
So Veronica Campbell Brown wins her second consecutive gold, 21.74. Second straight Olympic silver for Allyson Felix as the Jamaicans run 1-3. Karan Stewart got the bronze. Lee fourth and Hooker fifth. And Allyson Felix is with Bob Neumeier.
Well, Allyson, Otto Bolden just pointed out that you didn't look the same to him as you did in 2007 in that race. What do you see? How did you feel in that run?
You know, I felt prepared. I felt ready and just wasn't there today. But, I mean, God is good. I'm so blessed. And I'm thankful to be here.
Physically 100%?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't have any injuries or anything, so I gave it my all out there.
You had a nice moment with your family. Tell us about it.
Yeah, I mean, they've supported me all the way throughout, so it's going to be tough, but they're there for me.
Congratulations.
All right, thank you.
Allyson, gracious as always. We saw her give Veronica Campbell Brown a hug. She said they were friendly rivals in a talk with Bob yesterday. But Veronica Campbell Brown continues Jamaica's dominance of the sprints, men and women. Another gold medal for Jamaica.